In my previous video, I have shown you isotonic, hypotonic, and hypertonic solution by means of a small activity. Now let us learn about these solution and what is the impact of these solution around the cell by means of a PPT. So we have already learned that a solution is nothing but a homogeneous mixture of two or more substance and solute that is dissolved in another substance that is called solvent. And we are going to talk about all the solution in which solvent is water. We have also learned that tonicity, it refers to the solute concentration, and this is with respect to the comparison of the another solution that is present on other side of the cell membrane. Hypotonic solution are having less concentration of solute, and hypertonic solution are having more concentration of the solute. Iso, same concentration of the solute on either side of the cell membrane. Now let us see what is going to happen when an animal cell is kept in an hypotonic solution. The cell that you can see here is RBC. So what is going to happen when this RBC is going to be kept in hypotonic solution? Hypotonic, more water, less solute. So water will enter into the cell because water always moves from its high concentration to its low concentration. So sometime this may happen that cell might get burst due to excess uptake of water. And what is going to happen when an animal cell is kept in hypertonic solution? Hypertonic solution means less water outside and more water inside. So water will move from outside the cell to water will move from inside of the cell to outside. So cell will shrink. And when the cell is kept in isotonic solution, I think this is quite obvious that there is no net movement of water. Remember, we are using the word no net movement of water. It means if two molecules of water are entering inside, two are going to leave outside. Now let us see in case of plant cell. When a plant cell is kept in hypotonic solution, then water will enter inside the cell and the plant cell is having a vacuole. So this vacuole will take up the water and this is going to exert a pressure on the cell membrane and cell wall. Because of the rigid cell wall, this is not going to burst. Such a cell which is full of water is called a turgid cell, and this condition is very good for plant because this help in plant growth, this help in expansion of the leaf. But when a plant cell is kept in hypertonic solution, then what is going to happen? The cell membrane will shrink with the entire protoplasm content because water moves out of the cell. But the cell membrane is connected at certain places with the cell wall. And cell wall is rigid, so this is not going to shrink. So cell is going to maintain the shape. And this stage is called plasmolysis. We can deplasmolyze the cell. When a plasmolyzed cell is kept in hypotonic solution or in water, then this will regain the water and such a cell is called deplasmolyzed cell. When this is kept in isotonic solution, again same as we have done in case of animal cell, no net movement of water will take place, it will retain its shape. Now, what is going to happen? When an animal cell or plant cell is kept in either type of this solution, what type of the solution is best for the animal cell or for the plant cell? Should it be hypotonic? Should it be hypertonic? Should it be isotonic? We have seen that in case of hypotonic, animal cell may burst. In case of hypertonic, it shrinks. So the best option left with the animal cell is that outside the cell, solution should be isotonic. In case of plant cell, if it is isotonic, then the cell shape will remain same, but this is not going to help in the plant growth. If it is hypertonic, then cell may get plasmolyzed. Again, not good for the plant. But if a plant cell is kept in hypotonic solution, water will enter inside the cell. This will make it fully turgid, and this is good for plant growth. So the best type of the solution for the plant cell is hypotonic, but in case of animal cell, it is always isotonic.